Welcome back, students. In the last lecture, we have studied the vapor pressure of solution having two volatile liquids, Rawls' law, and also the ideal solution and non-ideal solution. We have also done the non-ideal behavior of the solutions like the positive deviation and negative deviation from Rawls' law. In today's lecture, we will study the colligative properties of non-electrolyte solutions. This is very important from the numerical point of view. In today's lecture, we will study the three properties. That is the vapor pressure lowering, boiling point elevation, and freezing point depression. Let's get started with the topic. Now, let us study the colligative properties of non-electrolyte solutions. The word colligative is derived from Greek word colligatus, meaning collected together. Colligative property means collective properties. These are the properties of solutions that depends only on the number of solute particles of the solution and not on the nature of the solute particles. यहाँ पे colligative property सिर्फ number of solute particles पे depend करेगा. यहाँ पे nature of the solute particles पे ये depend नहीं करता है. Here we will study four important colligative properties. These are vapor pressure lowering, boiling point elevation, freezing point depression, and osmotic pressure. Now, while dealing with the colligative properties of non-electrolyte solutions, the relatively dilute solutions with concentration 0.2 molar or less are considered. यहाँ दो तीन चीज आपको ध्यान रखनी है. पहली बात कि यहाँ पे ये प्रॉपर्टी नंबर ऑफ सॉल्यूट पार्टिकल्स पे डिपेंड करेगा. यहाँ पे जो भी सॉल्यूशंस लेंगे वो बहुत ही डाइल्यूट सॉल्यूशन रहेगा. तीसरी बात, यहाँ पे जो भी हम लोग सॉल्यूट लेंगे इट विल बी नॉन इलेक्ट्रोलाइट सॉलिड्स. वो क्या करेगा, सॉल्वेंट के साथ एग्रीगेट होके मॉलिक्यूल्स वगैरह नहीं बनाएगा एंड इट विल नॉट डिसोशिएट और एसोसिएट इन द सॉल्यूशन. So the number of particles of the solute does not change on dissolving it in the solvent. These colligative properties are used to determine the molar masses of non-electrolyte solutes. Now let us study the first colligative property, that is the vapor pressure lowering. ये लेक्चर के पहले आप पहला लेक्चर ज़रूर देखिए, क्योंकि उसमें हम लोग ने वेपर प्रेशर क्या होता है, सॉल्यूट सॉल्वेंट क्या होता है, वेपर प्रेशर कैसे कैलकुलेट करते हैं, वो सब हमने डिटेल में पढ़ा है. वो पढ़ के यदि वो लेक्चर अटेंड करके ये करेंगे तो आपको ईजिली समझ में आएगा. अभी यहाँ पे वेपर प्रेशर लोअरिंग नाम से ही समझ रहा है कि यहाँ पे क्या हो जाएगा, वेपर प्रेशर कम हो जाएगा. नाउ लेट अस ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड विद द हेल्प ऑफ दिस फिगर. सपोज वी टेक अ सॉल्वेंट विच इज़ अ वोलेटाइल इन नेचर. वोलेटाइल होगा इसका मतलब इसका खुद का कुछ ना कुछ वेपर प्रेशर होगा. तो लेट अस टेक एन सॉल्वेंट ए हुज वेपर प्रेशर इज P1 naught. ओके, नाउ the solute is dissolved in this solvent. Now the B, that is the solute, here we will take the non-volatile solute. Okay, suppose we take in the solvent mein hum log isme kya volatile jaise water hai, alcohol hai, benzene hai, toluene hai, ye sab jo hai volatile substance isko hum log solvent ke roop mein le sakte hain. Abhi isme humne B, that is solute, humne dissolve kiya. अभी बी जो होगा वो क्या होगा, नॉन वॉलेटाइल सॉल्यूट होगा, इसका खुद का कोई भी वेपर प्रेशर नहीं होगा। नॉन वॉलेटाइल मतलब वो वेपर फेस में जाएगा ही नहीं, इसकी वजह से उसका कोई भी प्रेशर क्रिएट नहीं होगा। तो कोई भी नॉन वॉलेटाइल सब्सटेंस जैसे कि मोस्ट कॉमनली लेते हैं यूरिया, ग्लूकोस, सुक्रोस, ये सब इनमें से कोई यदि सॉल्यूट को हम लोग यदि सॉल्वेंट में डिजोल्व करते हैं तो क्या होगा, इसका खुद का कोई वेपर प्रेशर नहीं होगा। ठीक है, तो यह जब इसको हम लोग डिजोल्व करके जब सॉल्यूशन बनाएंगे तो यहाँ पे एक है वॉलेटाइल सॉल्वेंट और दूसरा है नॉन वॉलेटाइल सॉल्यूट। तो यहाँ पे सिर्फ जो वेपर प्रेशर होगा वो किसकी वजह से होगा, सिर्फ सॉल्वेंट की वजह से। तो हम लोग इसमें ऐसा बोल सकते हैं क्या कि जो वेपर प्रेशर सॉल्वेंट का है वही टोटल प्रेशर होगा। लेकिन एक्सपेरिमेंटली ये देखा गया है कि जब भी नॉन वॉलेटाइल सॉल्यूट को इस तरह से वॉलेटाइल सॉल्वेंट में डिजोल्व करके जब भी सॉल्यूशन बनता है देर इज अ डिक्रीज इन द टोटल प्रेशर। तो ये प्रेशर डिक्रीज कैसे होगा, दैट वी हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड। सपोज वी टेक अ सॉल्यूट एंड दैट इज डिजोल्व इन अ सॉल्वेंट। यहाँ पे सॉल्वेंट में क्या होगा, सरफेस में हमको मालूम है जितने भी सरफेस है यहाँ से क्या होगा, वेपर फॉर्म में वो कन्वर्ट होगा। ठीक है, जब भी हम इसमें सॉल्यूट डिजोल्व करेंगे उस टाइम में क्या होगा, ये जो सॉल्वेंट पार्टिकल्स है इनके बीच में ये जो नॉन वॉलेटाइल जो है भी सॉल्यूट पार्टिकल्स है ये ए के बीच में आके अपने आप को एडजस्ट करेगा। तो ये मॉलिक्यूल्स जाके ए के बीच में जब एडजस्ट करेगा तो क्या होगा, जितना वेपर फॉर्म होना चाहिए ऊपर सरफेस के ऊपर से जितना एवोपरेट होना चाहिए, जितना वेपर्स फॉर्म होना चाहिए उतना नहीं होगा क्योंकि बीच में नॉन वॉलेटाइल सॉल्यूट्स प्रेजेंट है। तो ये हिंडर करेगा कि वेपर्स जा कम कर देगा, जितना ऊपर जाना है उतना पॉसिबल नहीं होगा। इसकी वजह से क्या होगा, जितना सॉल्वेंट का जो वेपर प्रेशर था वहाँ पे जाके क्या हो जाएगा, ये सॉल्यूट पार्टिकल्स की वजह से वहाँ पे कम वेपर्स फॉर्म होंगे। यदि कम वेपर्स फॉर्म होगा तो क्या होगा, प्रेशर भी कम होगा। इस तरह से जब भी वॉलेटाइल सॉल्वेंट में जब भी हम नॉन वॉलेटाइल सॉल्यूट ऐड करते हैं तो इसका जो वेपर प्रेशर है वो कम हो जाता है। इसको हम लोग इस तरह से देख सकते हैं, हियर पी वन दैट इज द टोटल प्रेशर दैट विल बी ऑलवेज लेस देन द प्रेशर ऑफ द सॉल्वेंट दैट इज गिवन हियर पी वन। हियर पी वन इज द टोटल प्रेशर एंड पी वन नॉट इज द वेपर प्रेशर ऑफ द सॉल्वेंट। सो वी कैन राइट द वेपर प्रेशर लोअरिंग विल बी इक्वल्स टू डेल्टा पी दैट इज इक्वल टू पी नॉट पी वन नॉट माइनस पी वन। नाउ वी हैव स्टडीड द रॉल्स लॉ इन द लास्ट लेक्चर। What does this law states? It states that the partial vapor pressure of any volatile component of a solution is the product of vapor pressure of that pure component and the mole fraction of the component in the solution. So here if we see, यहाँ पर जब हम इसको अप्लाई करेंगे क्योंकि सॉल्यूट का तो कोई वेपर प्रेशर है ही नहीं, तो दिस लॉ विल बी ओनली अप्लीकेबल टू द सॉल्वेंट। सो हियर वी कैन राइट टोटल प्रेशर दैट इज पी वन दैट इज इक्वल्स टू पी वन नॉट एक्स वन। ओके, नाउ फॉर द बाइनरी सोल्यूशन वी नो दैट द मोल फ्रैक्शन दैट इज एक्स वन प्लस एक्स टू दैट इज इक्वल्स टू वन दैट इज यूनिटी। सो वी कैन राइट एक्स वन इक्वल्स टू वन माइनस एक्स टू। सो पुटिंग दिस वैल्यू वी विल गेट पी वन इक्वल्स टू पी वन नॉट एक्स वन। ओके, नाउ एंड पुटिंग दिस वैल्यू वी विल गेट पी वन नॉट वन माइनस यर एक्स एक्स टू। नाउ ऑन फर्दर सॉल्विंग वी विल गेट पी वन नॉट माइनस पी वन दैट इज इक्वल्स टू पी वन नॉट एक्स टू। नाउ वी नो दैट पी वन नॉट माइनस पी वन दैट इज इक्वल टू डेल्टा पी। सो पुटिंग दिस वैल्यू वी विल गेट डेल्टा पी इक्वल्स टू पी वन नॉट एक्स टू। नाउ हियर इफ यू सी that delta P depends on the X2. Now what is X2 here? That is a number of solute particles. Thus delta P, the lowering of vapor pressure is a colligative property. Now we can find the relative lowering of vapor pressure. Here, the ratio of vapor pressure lowering of the solvent, that is delta P, is divided by the vapor pressure of the pure solvent, that is P1 naught. That will be equals to P1 naught minus P1 upon P1 naught. Here we can write that delta P upon P1 naught, that is equals to x2, that is equal to P1 naught minus P1 upon P1 naught. This relative lowering of vapor pressure is equal to the mole fraction of the solute in the solution. Therefore, this relative vapor pressure lowering is a colligative property. यहाँ पे नंबर ऑफ सॉल्यूट दैट इज x2 पे ये डिपेंड करेगा, इसीलिए इसको हम लोग कॉलिगेटिव प्रॉपर्टी बोलेंगे. नाउ वी कैन कैलकुलेट द मोलार मास ऑफ सॉल्यूट फ्रॉम द वेपर प्रेशर लोअरिंग. नाउ फ्रॉम द इक्वेशन वी नो दैट डेल्टा पी अपॉन P1 naught, that is equals to x2. Here the mole fraction of a component of a solution is equal to its moles divided by the total moles in the solution. That is x2 will be equals to n2 upon n1 plus n2, where n1 and n2 are the moles of solvent and solute respectively. Here we are taking dilute solution. So we can write n1 is much larger than n2. Hence n2 may be neglected in comparison with the n1 in the equation. So here the mole fraction x2 is then given by x2 equals to n2 upon n1, and delta p upon p1 naught, that is equals to n2 upon n1. Now, if we prepare a solution by dissolving W2 grams of a solute in W1 gram of solvent, then the moles of solute and solvent in this solution will be N2 will be equals to W2 upon M2, and N1 will be equals to W1 upon M1. Here M1 and M2 are the molar masses of the solvent and solute respectively. Substituting this in the equation, we will get x2 equals to delta p upon p1 naught equals to w2 upon m2 upon w1 upon m1. p1 naught minus p1 upon p1 naught, that will be equals to delta p upon p1 naught, that will be equals to w2 m1 upon m2 W1. From this equation, we can calculate the molar mass of solute M2. Now we know in solutions of non-volatile solutes, the law is applicable only to the volatile solvents. Here if we plot a graph, that is the vapor pressure of solvent versus mole fraction of the solvent, we will get a straight line like this. Now let us solve one numerical related to this. Now the vapor pressure of pure benzene at certain temperature is 640 mm mercury. A non-volatile solute of mass 2.175 into 10 raised to power minus 3 kg is added to 39.0 into 10 raised to power minus 3 kg of benzene. The vapor pressure of the solution is 600 mm mercury. What is the molar mass of the solute? Here given the atomic mass of carbon is 12 and hydrogen is 1. Now what all is given here? Here P1 naught is given, W1 is given, W2, M1, and we have to find out M2. So we will use this formula, and by solving further we will get the molar mass. We have seen that vapor pressure is lowered when non-volatile solute is added to the volatile solvent to form solution. It has been experimentally found that the boiling point of solvent is elevated by dissolving a non-solute into it. The solution containing non-volatile solutes boils at temperature higher than the boiling point of the pure solvent. You all know what is boiling point. Here the boiling point of a liquid is the temperature at which the vapor pressure equals to the atmospheric pressure. Now if TB naught is the boiling point of the pure solvent and TB is that of the solution, then TB will be greater than T naught B. The difference between the boiling point of the solution and that of the pure solvent at any given constant temperature pressure is called the boiling point elevation. Let us try to understand the elevation of boiling point by comparing the vapor pressure of solution and that of the pure solvent. The vapor pressures of solution and pure solvent are plotted as a function of temperature, as you can see here. Now, we have studied that at any temperature, the vapor pressure of a solution is lower than that of the pure solvent. Hence, the vapor pressure temperature curve of solution CD, as you can see here, lies below that of the solvent AB. The difference between the two vapor pressure increases as the temperature and vapor pressure increases. Now, the intersection of the curve CD with the line corresponding to 760 mm is the boiling point of the solution. The similar intersection of the curve AB is the boiling point of the pure solvent. It is clear from the figure that the boiling point, that is TB, of the solution is higher than that of the pure solvent, that is PB naught. At the boiling point of a liquid, its vapor pressure is equal to 1 atmosphere. In order to reach the boiling point, the solution and solvent must be heated to a temperature at which their respective vapor pressure attains 1 atmosphere. At a given temperature, the vapor pressure of a solution is lower than that of the pure solvent. Hence, the vapor pressure of the solution needs higher temperature to reach that atmosphere than that needed for the vapor pressure of a solvent. In other words, the solution must be heated to higher temperature to cause it to boil than the pure solvent. ये clear है कि जब भी vapor pressure यहाँ पे low होगा तो क्या होगा कि solution में जो है यदि वहाँ पे जो है atmospheric उतना atmospheric pressure reach करने के लिए हमको क्या करना पड़ेगा, higher temperature उसको देना पड़ेगा. इसीलिए यहाँ पे जो boiling point है solution का वो higher हो जाता है. Now the boiling point elevation is directly proportional to the molality of the solution. Last हमने vapor pressure के इसमें हमने molality लिया था. इधर पे हम लोग ने molality लिया. क्यों बता सकते हो आप लोग? क्योंकि यहाँ पर हम लोग molality नहीं ले सकते हैं, क्योंकि जो molality जो term है वो temperature dependent है और यहाँ पे temperature डिफरेंस आएगा. इसकी वजह से हमको, क्योंकि मोलालिटी जो है दैट इज इंडिपेंडेंट ऑफ द टेम्परेचर, सो वी विल टेक द टर्म मोलालिटी. नाउ दिस डेल्टा टी बी दैट इज डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू एम, दैट इज द मोलालिटी. नाउ वी विल रिमूव द प्रोपोर्शनैलिटी साइन एंड पुट अ कॉन्स्टेंट. सो हियर द प्रोपोर्शनैलिटी कॉन्स्टेंट के बी, that is called as the boiling point elevation constant or molal elevation constant or ebullioscopic constant is used. Now what is this ebullioscopic constant? Now here experiment that is the experimental method to determine a mass of non-volatile solute by determining boiling point of a pure solvent and solution of known concentration is known as ebullioscopy. So they have given this ebullioscopic constant. Now this delta TB is equals to KBm. Suppose if we take m equals to 1, then what will happen? Delta TB will be equals to KB. Now remember, this KB totally depends on the solvent. It does not depend upon the solute. And mostly in the examination numericals also, this value is always given. It is fixed for a given solvent. Now this, what is will be the unit of KB? Now this we can calculate, KB will be equals to delta TB upon M. So putting this units, we will get for TB, that is temperature, we will take Kelvin upon moles per kg. So here the unit of KB will be Kelvin kg per mole. Now we know that delta TB is directly proportional to molality. Now this molality is equals to what? It is the number of moles of solute present in 1 kg of the solvent. So here we are using the number of solutes so that it will be a colligative property. Now suppose if W2 grams of solute with molar mass M2 is dissolved in W1 gram of solvent, then molality will be equals to mass of solute in kg upon molar mass of solute in kg per mole into mass of solvent in kg. Now putting this M equals to, we will get W2 upon M2 into W1. Substituting this value of molality in equation 1, we will get delta TB equals to KB into W2 upon M2W1. Therefore, M2 will be equals to KBW2 upon delta TB into W1. Now, if you want to express this kg in grams, so then the equation will become M2 equals to KB into W2 upon delta P TB into W1 into 1000. So these are some of the formula here that you can use for the numericals. Now let us solve some of the numericals related to elevation in boiling point. Now here 0.15 molal solution of substance boils at 373.23 Kelvin. Calculate the molal elevation constant of water. Here first you have to calculate delta TB. Okay, so delta TB equals to KB into M. We have to find out KB. First we will calculate delta TB and then putting this value in this equation, we will get the answer. Okay, another example is the calculate the molality of a solution. Here we have to calculate the molality. Calculate the molality of a solution of substance which on dissolving in benzene boils at 353.71 Kelvin. KB for benzene is 2.53 Kelvin kg per mole and boiling point of pure benzene is 353.35 K. Again here you have to find out the delta TB first, then putting this value M in M equals to delta TB upon KB, you will get the answer. One more example is 3.795 gram of sulfur is dissolved in 100 gram of carbon disulfide. This solution boils at 319.81 Kelvin. What is the molecular formula of sulfur in the solution? The boiling point of solvent is 319.45 Kelvin. First, what all is given here? Here KB is given and the atomic mass of sulfur is also given. Now we know that M2 equals to, that is in grams we can convert 1000 into kb into w2 upon delta tb into w1. Now first we have to find out here the delta tb. Okay, this will come out to be 0.36 Kelvin. Now putting this value in m2, we can solve further. So I have given the three examples related to three formulae of delta tb. Like this you can solve many more numericals. In the examination, most of the time numericals are asked on solutions chapters. Now let us study the depression in freezing point. By general experiments, it has been observed that the freezing point of solvent is lowered by dissolving a non-volatile solute into it. Thus, the freezing point of solution containing a non-volatile solute is lower than that of the pure solvent. If TF0 is the freezing point of pure solvent and TF is that of the solution in which non-volatile solute is dissolved, then TF0 will be greater than TF. The difference between the freezing point of pure solvent and that of the solution is depression in freezing point. It is given by delta TF equals to TF0 minus TF. Freezing point is defined as the temperature at which vapor pressure of liquid state becomes equal to the vapor pressure of the solid state. Now, let us try to understand the depression in freezing point with the help of this figure. In this figure, if you see, now consider the vapor pressure temperature in this diagram. Here, the diagram consists of three curves as you can see. Here, AB is the vapor pressure curve of the solid solvent. Okay, now the CD is the vapor pressure curve of pure liquid, that is solvent. And EF is the vapor pressure of the curve of solution that always lies below the pure solvent. We have seen in the elevation in boiling point also. Now here it is important to note that the solute does not dissolve in the solid solvent. Now if you see the curve AB and CD intersects at point B, where the solid and liquid phases of the pure solvent are in equilibrium. The two phases have the same vapor pressure at B. The temperature corresponding to B is the freezing point of solvent that we have done, that is the TF0. Similarly at E, the point of intersection of EF, if you see, that is EF and AB, the solid solvent and solution are in equilibrium. They have the same vapor pressure at E. The temperature corresponding to E is the freezing point of solution, that is TF. It is clear from the figure that the freezing point of solution TF is lower than that of the pure solvent TF0. It is obvious because the vapor pressure curve of solution lies below that of the solvent. Now why this freezing point of solvent is low? This at the freezing point of pure liquid, the attractive force among the molecules are large enough to cause the change of phase from the liquid to solid. यहाँ पर सॉल्वेंट में अट्रैक्टिव फोर्स ज़्यादा होता है. जब इसको हम लोग सॉल्यूट में डिसॉल्व करते हैं तो सॉल्वेंट मॉलिक्यूल्स के बीच में सॉल्यूट पार्टिकल्स आ जाता है. इसकी वजह से वो उसको फ्रीज करने के लिए हमको और टेम्परेचर को लोअर करना पड़ता है. So the separation of solvent molecules in solution is more than that in the pure solvent. This results in decreasing in the attractive force between the solvent molecules, and consequently the temperature of the solution is lowered below the freezing point of solvent to cause the phase change. Now, experimentally, it is proved that for a dilute solution, the freezing point depression, that is delta TF, is directly proportional to the molality of the solution. Thus, we can write delta TF, that is directly proportional to M, or we can write delta TF equals to KFM. The proportionality constant KF is called as the freezing point depression constant or cryoscopic constant. Here the cryoscopy is the experimental method to determine the molecular mass of non-volatile solute by determining the freezing point of pure solvent and solution of known concentration. This is known as cryoscopy. So this constant is known as cryoscopic constant. Now the unit of this KF, that will be equals to delta TF upon M, that is equals to, that is temperature we take in Kelvin or degree Celsius upon moles per kg. So the unit of KF will be Kelvin kg per mole or degree Celsius kg per mole. Now here delta TF is equals to KFM. The molality M of the solution is given by M equals to, that we have done earlier also. So if we want to express in grams, we will write 1000 into W2 upon M2 into W1. Substituting these values, we will get delta TF equals to KF 1000 W2 upon M2 W1. And from this we can calculate M2, that is M2 will be equals to 1000 KF into W2 upon delta TF W1. Now let us solve one numerical related to this. Calculate the freezing point of solution prepared by dissolving 4.5 gram of glucose. Here molar mass of glucose is given, that is 180 grams per mole in 250 gram of bromoform. Here freezing point of bromoform, that is given 7.8 degree Celsius, and KF for bromoform, that is 14.4 Kelvin kg per mole. Here we have to calculate the freezing point of solution, and the freezing point of solvent, that is given 7.8 degrees Celsius. Okay, we know that delta TF, that is equal to freezing point of solvent minus freezing point of solution. Here first we have to calculate delta TF. Okay, then we will put this value here. So delta TF, that is equals to KF into W2 upon M2 into W1. By putting the values and solving further, we will get 1.44 Kelvin, or you can say degree Celsius here. Now here delta TF, that is equals to freezing point of solvent minus freezing point of solution. Okay, so here the freezing point of solution equals to freezing point of solvent minus delta TF. So 7.8 degrees Celsius minus 1.44 degrees Celsius will give 6.36 degrees Celsius. By this way we can solve. You have to solve more and more numericals, then the concept will be more clear to you. Now let us summarize the topic. In today's lecture, we have studied the colligative properties. The properties of solution which depends on the number of solute particles in a solution is called as colligative property. It is independent of the nature of the solute. Now, the various type of colligative properties, in your syllabus there are four types of colligative properties. In that we have done the three of them. First one was the lowering of vapor pressure. Vapor pressure of a solution containing non-volatile solute is lower than that of the pure solvent, that we have seen. Second, we have done the elevation of boiling point. Elevation means increase. The solution containing non-volatile solute boils at higher temperature than the boiling point of the pure solvent. And we have also done the depression of freezing point. Here depression means decrease. Here the freezing point of solution containing non-volatile solute is lower than that of the pure solvent. So three of the properties we have done in the today's lecture, and the fourth one we will be doing in the next lecture. Hope you are all growing by learning. Stay home, stay safe. Thank you.